Hello and welcome back to another episode of Vacuum Insanity. It's a very hot day today, so what better way to deal with that than to vacuum some floors? So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to review this model I found, which I will show you now. So here it is. At first, when I saw this, I picked it up and I actually thought it was an Electrolux, but it's not. I think maybe they went for a design that kind of looks like it. It's called Day Useful Everyday Vacuum Cleaner. It seems like a generic brand. It even has these big stickers on it. It doesn't really look so impressive. Also, the just the entire surface of it is cheap plastic. It doesn't feel good. Even the buttons here, look at this, very loose. Let me see. It's made in Kolding, Denmark. So it's a Danish vacuum cleaner. It has, I guess it has a name, but let me try to show you. I think this it's just called vacuum cleaner. So, and then it has this number here, it's 700 watt. I don't know why it says hertz here, 60 hertz, 50, 60 hertz, I have no idea, but it's 700 watt. So I guess let's test this nameless vacuum cleaner. So I'm going to use a different kind of surface today than I usually do. Usually I use floor. Today I'm going to use a mattress, a dirty old mattress, to really see the potential of this vacuum cleaner. So here it is. As you can see, it's quite dirty. So we would expect this vacuum cleaner, which does support different modes, one for carpet and one for, I suppose, wooden floor. I suppose this would be more like carpet, so that's what we're going to use. Other than that, it just uses a regular old cable. God damn it. So let's try that. Oh, okay. So you have different noise levels here as well. Let's start with a low one. See how that goes. Okay. Wait a second. There we go. Oh fuck. Okay, here we are. Okay. Now this is not very good. Look at this. When I do this, it doesn't really pick up all the little things. So let's try to pull out the higher one, y'all. It has no suction at all. Like there's no feeling of it actually sucking out. So that's not very good. Like it does an okay job right here, but it almost has no suction at all. As you could probably see, I had some difficulties shutting the vacuum cleaner off. An overall indicator of just the low, poor quality. Overall, this was a short review, but yeah, overall, the vacuum cleaner was a piece of garbage. And just the fact that it doesn't really have a name, it's just called vacuum cleaner, it's just an indicator of the overall poor quality. So it gets a thumbs down from me, and I'll see you next time on Vacuum Insanity.